Hey everyone, and welcome back. Today, we're going to be reviewing Very Valet for the Nintendo Switch. Now this game currently released both on the eShop and physically. On the eShop, it is being sold for $24.99, and it is pretty much a dedicated couch co-op game. Now the question is, does this game help the party keep going, or unfortunately, does it lead it to a crash and burn? Well, we're going to answer that today in our review of Very Valet. Now, just before we get started, don't forget that if you do like this content and you want to see some more, please hit the like button. It's the best way to support the channel. And subscribe if you aren't already. Now, the basic premise of this game is very simple. You work for a valet agency that pretty much takes on any job it can find, no matter how unusual. But let's be clear. Don't expect much storyline here, because this game really, other than a very slight introduction to each stage, pretty much throws you straight into the gameplay. And the only time that the game actually tries to inject a tiny bit of storyline is when you're getting close to the final missions on the game, but we'll actually get to that just a little bit later. But let's be honest, no one's picking this game up for the storyline. You're basically picking it up for the awesome multiplayer co-op mode. So for the moment, let's jump right into that gameplay. The basic gameplay loop is very simple. NPCs will drop their vehicles off to be parked. You can park them generally anywhere on the screen that is not indicated as a no park zone. And then you simply wait for them to end their shopping, eating, or whatever other activity they're doing to ask for their vehicles back. At that point, you jump in those vehicles and drive them back to the pickup zone, which is basically indicated by a yellow marker. Now, if that sounds simple enough, it is because it is. And that is the premise of a party game like this. You want at least the basics of the gameplay to be very quick to learn and understand. Now, the controls themselves are also, once again, very simple. When you're next to a vehicle, if you press the A button, your character will jump in and take control of that vehicle. To jump out, you simply press the B button. When you're actually on board one of the vehicles, with your left joystick, you're going to be basically able to control the vehicle and have it go in whichever direction you point. If you need to do a tighter turn, if you hold the Y button down, you will hit the E-brake, giving you the ability to turn much tighter. The actual only mechanic that is a tiny bit tricky is switching from forward gear to reverse gear. Basically, that's done by leaving the left joystick idle for a fraction of a second and then hitting the opposite direction. And actually getting control of that one more complex mechanic is going to be the biggest hurdle you're going to have when you're playing this game that will help you eventually graduate to being much more efficient. Now that pretty much sums it up for the actual controls and gameplay in this game. They're very simple, but that's what you want in a party game. Next, however, where you get your variety is from the actual content. Now, the content itself in the game is broken up into 24 different levels, and each level is basically unlocked through successful completion of the previous one. When you successfully complete a level, you'll also be awarded a score out of 3 stars. How many stars you get will depend on how many vehicles you unfortunately were unsuccessful at either picking up or dropping off to its NPC. Basically, each unsuccessful vehicle will remove a star. At 3 unsuccessful vehicles, you'll actually get a score of 0 stars, meaning that it won't actually contribute to your overall progress in the game. It's also important to note that among the 24 levels, there are 4 levels that could be called bonus levels, one per overall subdivision of the game section. Now, these bonus levels basically flip up the average gameplay of the game and give you different types of objectives. One, you'll be knocking over bowling pins, another one, you'll be picking up garbage, and even driving a street sweeper. Now, if you're wondering why it's important to be collecting these different stars through the different levels, it's that pretty much every 6 levels, you'll have sort of a gatekeeper level where you'll have to have acquired a certain levels of stars to basically progress further in the game. So when you reach that 6th level, if you unfortunately don't have enough stars, you'll have to grind through one of the previous levels to acquire those extra stars if you want to see any of the further levels. So now that we've gone through the basic gameplay, the controls, and also the overall content that's included in Very Valet, let's look at some of the things I really liked about the game. Now, the first thing and probably most important for a party game, and I already pointed to this earlier, is that the controls are very easy to pick up and play, which is essential for a game like this. Because if you have a few friends coming over, you can throw a controller in their hand, and after 4 or 5 minutes, they'll know exactly what they're supposed to do to be successful in the game. Secondly, the levels that are present in the game are very varied and diverse, with no two levels really feeling like a repeat of the previous one, or no levels seeming as superfluous or unnecessary. Also, the fact that they included different types of vehicles that have different speeds and different handling was a nice, unexpected surprise that actually added quite a bit to the overall gameplay. The overall animations as well on the characters and the vehicles was very, very fluid, and I actually detected no performance issues through any of my playthroughs, even in playing in multiplayer mode with 4 people on the screen. Everything was running with no stuttering. And personally, I have to say that the overall appearance in the game is very, very appealing. And the Muppet-like designs that they used for the characters is both really adequate for adult players and young players as well. My kids actually really enjoyed choosing their characters, changing their colors, and all the variations that were offered on that end of the game. And lastly, I would say that the bonus stages were another nice surprise that really gave a fresh change of pace to the overall gameplay of the average stages. Now let's talk about a few of the points that I won't necessarily say are all negative, but I think you should be very well aware of before actually picking up this game. Now the first of these issues that I think you should be aware of has to do with the fact that they chose to use ragdoll physics for this game. Now, I'm not saying it's a bad choice because I really don't see this game working any other way. But due to the fact that this game is based on that type of physics system, sometimes failure will feel more due to the overall lack of control from this type of physics system than the actual lack of skill from your own gameplay. Now, if you're just playing this game as a casual fun game, it's not really going to be an issue. But if you're a competitive type of person that will get frustrated when your character or vehicle doesn't exactly react the way you thought it was going to react in each and every situation, well then unfortunately, sometimes you'll just get frustrated. The second overall issue is maybe one that is of slight more importance. And to me, it was the actual overall content that's included in the game. I mean, the 24 stages, as I said, that are included in this game earlier are really good and very varied. However, there are only 24 stages, and unlocking them, for me personally, only took about 2 or 3 hours. Now, obviously, this is not a game that was made to be played once through each level and then tossed to the side. As I said earlier, it's a party game, and actually 3-starring all of the levels will take probably a few tries for most people. I can't help but compare it to other series that are offering the same type of gameplay or overall environment out there. The Overcooked series comes to mind right away, and especially if we compare it to Overcooked 2 that has a pretty similar sales price, well, the overall content included in that game is much more vast than what we're getting in Very Very Valet. And the last point is once again maybe one of slightly lesser importance, but as I mentioned a little earlier, they did try to inject a tiny bit of storyline moving into those last few levels. However, I really feel like their attempt to inject that storyline really missed the mark. And I don't want any spoilers, so I'm not going to explain why, but I'm pretty sure when you get into those last few levels and you actually see what the payoff storyline wise is in the last level, you'll be a little bit disappointed with what you get, and they don't give you that big finale or that big last level I was really hoping for. Now, before we actually move on to the scoring, however, there are a couple of intangibles that I want to go over. And the first thing I would like to mention is that although you've probably noticed, all the gameplay you're seeing in the background was filmed with only one player. That is simply because my capture setup is really tough to do in a multiplayer setup. However, most of the actual gameplay that I used to review this game was a multiplayer setup with my wife and kids. But unfortunately, as I said earlier, it was very difficult to capture that overall gameplay. Therefore, I played through the game alone to basically get most of the footage that you're seeing here. And that leads us actually directly into that intangible. And that is the fact that I played this game with my kids and my wife. And on my kids' end, this became their favorite party game. They actually enjoy it more than the Overcooked series. Me and my wife, personally, we still prefer Overcooked. But on the kids' end, they really fell in love with Very Very Valet. probably because the gameplay is actually easier overall than the Overcooked series. And as I said, the characters were more inviting to them than the characters from that other series. So although I will give this review based on my expectations for this game, I did want to throw that out there that for my kids, it actually became their favorite couch co-op style game currently. So now let's move on to the official scoring on this game. If this is the first review of mine that you're watching, I just want to let you all know I do not give a numerical score. I give an overall statement on whether I think you should be picking up the game or not. If you want to see what all those different statements I use are, they're all down below in the description of the video. And in the case of Very Very Valet, I'm going to be giving this game a solid game. But it's going to be a very high solid game, and actually, once this game hits some major sales, I would say once it hits below the $15 mark, it will easily drop into definite pickup territory for anyone looking for a party multiplayer game. Because as I said earlier, the only thing that at present is sort of holding it back is the overall quantity of content that's included. If we had an extra 10 to 20 levels included here, this game would automatically fall into the definite pickup territory. And who knows, I'm still crossing my fingers that maybe this game will be getting some free DLC with some extra levels thrown in here and there after a couple of months. So that's pretty much it for my review of Very Very Valet. Now I want to hear from all of you. Are you going to be picking up the game? Did you already pick it up? And what did you overall think? Leave it in the comments down below. Now just on the way out, don't forget that as usual, if you did like this content, please hit the like button. It's the best way to support the channel. Also subscribe if you aren't already, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when all my future videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see you in my next video.